exclusive hot new
high school holla.
Here it comes.
Hello, Chicago. Steven Spurrier, everyone from Chicago and all surrounding areas, to the best show for high school sports in Chicago, the H2S2 show, and our new segment, the H2S2 post-game show, as we bring you post-game interviews with coaches and players from games played this week around the Chicago Public League. We take a virtual air ride up north to the border of North Park and Albany Park neighborhood. Joining us is a good friend of the show, Von Steuben, head football coach Dave Rivera, whose Panthers enter this week off of a shutoff win of the Sullivan Tigers last week. And this week took a win over the Mather Rangers, 42-6. Coach, thank you guys for joining us again, man. Welcome.
Thanks for having us back, Spoon. I appreciate it. Appreciate you giving us a voice and highlighting our players that that deserve some recognition. So I appreciate it.
Coach, you got to talk about the team's performance in these weeks versus last week. What changed, man? You guys are balling out this week.
I felt like, we did improve from week one. So we did play well. Our defense played well in week one. Our offense was still trying to find itself a little bit in week one. I mean, that's to be expected with just 2.5 weeks of practice before our first game. So our defense played well. And then coming into this week, our offense found itself a little bit. We were able to make some adjustments. We were able to highlight some of the playmakers that you see on the screen here today. Just getting the ball out to our playmakers. That was one of the main points that we wanted to make. We figured out some issues with our offensive line. We got a young offensive line. We got three freshmen and two seniors that are playing new positions. So, that always takes a little bit to gel. Offensive line play is not easy. You can't just throw them together and expect perfect performances right off the bat. So, but we're working through it. We got committed players. We got dedicated players that listen to the coaches and work hard. And so, fortunately we've been able to rely on our defense a little bit. And then our offense found its way a little bit against Mather as well. So, hopefully it'll just get better each week.
Coach, tell us who we got right here joining you on today.
So I'll start with our seniors. We got Ahmad Evans, who has shined our first two games. Ahmad, you see him there, he's at work. But, Ahmad, what stands out to me about Ahmad, what I want you all to know about Ahmad is that he's putting the time in the offseason. He's just the guy that deserves the success that he's having right now. So, like I said, he had a terrific offseason, and he's starting to show on the field now. He's had exceptional performances in the first two games. And then we have Jimmy Cole, who's also a senior. Jimmy does a lot for us on offense and defense on both sides of the ball. It just means so much to our team. Also not only on the stat sheet, but also just morale-wise, the team kind of rallies around him. Then our young bucks, our juniors, we got little Jimmy Simmons Jr., who he's getting his time at starting running back position this year. He's the guy that we expect is going to be good for us for not only this year but next year. Also plays some safety on the defensive back on the defensive end. So Jimmy Simmons does a lot for us as well. And then Kamen Coleman Jr. As well, that plays on both sides of the ball really well. Starting wide receiver, starting cornerback for us. So all of these guys here play on both sides of the ball. They do a little bit of everything for us. So I'm really, really happy to have them.
Ahmad Evans, hey, 192 all-purpose yards, one passing touchdown, one receiving touchdown, two rushing touchdowns, four tackles. Ahmad, you must be very, very good out there on the gridiron, man. How does it feel to be the shining star and help your team win?
I mean, it's not just a V sport, it's a team sport, but it feels good to see that all the offseason work turn up. It's great.
Jimmy put in big five rushes, five carries, 54 yards, and a touchdown, along with 11 tackles. Two of those was for a loss.
Big play from my man JC Jimmy Coles. 11 tackles and 2 for a loss, along with a touchdown. Jimmy, you got to feel good about those numbers, man.
Yeah, I feel good about it. And yeah.
Kamen Coleman, 3 catches, 64 yards, and a TD with 1 interception. That's playing it on both sides of the ball. Kamen, good game for you, baby.
I appreciate it, Mr. Ram.
And last but not least, we have little Jimmy, as they call him, Jimmy Simmons Jr., 1 rushing touchdown, 51 all-purpose yards. Good game for him as well. How do you feel about those numbers, little Jimmy?
I mean, I feel fine. More to come.
You know, he also got a run that was called back due to a penalty, so his rushing yards should have come up. And he did have some good runs for us, so you know, part of that as well.
Hey, well, we're not gonna. We'll add that on the unofficial stats, little Jimmy. So don't worry about that. We're gonna put that on the stat books anyway. I want to ask you guys, how does it feel with this pandemic and being able to play football again?
I mean, it's nice. It's more of a blessing than it is, because it got taken away like really quick. So now that it's back, it's like it feels kind of somewhat normal again. But yeah.
And Jimmy Coleman, I want to ask you, you are playing behind these guys and not playing with them guys. How has that changed your perspective to the game? What have you learned from these two seniors?
For me, them just taking leadership during this time, like during the offseason, even though we didn't know we was going to have a season tonight, they still trained and made each other better overall. So, yeah.
All that's gone through and preparing in a pandemic season, has it given you a new respect for the game of football?
Oh, for sure. I actually, you know, like I just feel blessed to, you know, be able to, you know, be playing. I know there's people, you know, less fortunate than us. And, you know, just, you know, being with the pandemic and everything, you know, not being able to play for such a long time, it made me realize, like, how much I really need to work at it and get better if I want to go somewhere with it.
Hey, well, I appreciate you, our shining stars of the game, for joining us. I want to give each of you an opportunity. Let's start with the senior. Ahmad, who do you want to give hollers out to that's a part of supporting not only Von Steuben, but this Panther football team? We're going to start with the senior. Who do you want to give a big holler out to, Ahmad?
I
want
to give a shout out to Coach Leg and my dad and like everybody that was like training me in the offseason. Without them, I wouldn't be where I'm at now. Shout out Coach Rivera for even getting the program back started again. And all the coaches for letting me just play.
I want to shout out to Coach Rivera and coaching staff and my football players, because they've been with me from my hardest times in my life, and my mom and my family, you know, the teachers. Everybody's really supportive. So, yeah.
Give a shout out to my, you know, my mother and my father, you know, just being so supportive of me. You know, my father, you know, helped me put on, you know, like a lot of weight, you know, to get ready for the season, helping me with my speed and everything. I also want to shout out to my coaches, you know, for, you know, just, you know, being there for us, you know, just teaching us new things every practice. And my teammates for just giving me 100% every practice, wanting to be there.
Shout out to my coaches and both of my parents for allowing me to play through this pandemic, because I know that even though some people want to play football still or any other sport, they're probably not able to due to their parents being scared for them. So them allowing me to play still, I'm happy.
Next, I think we got a big game coming up. Who's next on the calendar for you, baby?
You know, we got Amis and Vikings up next. That's a rivalry game for us. It's a game that, you know, it's been a good back and forth battle since we started our program in 2016. So I know we're looking forward to it. I know they're looking forward to it. You know, so it's something that is, you know, something that we feel, you know, got started off in 2016. Actually, one of the, you know, just a little note is that our first varsity victory was against Amundsen in 2016. So our first IHSA win ever was against Amundsen in 2016. you know, I had the pleasure of being part of that as well. So I've been a part of it, of it every year. And so I think it's special. I think it's unique. I think it's good. I think it's healthy. And I think it's a lot of fun for both schools and both student bodies. I know the players know each other. We're 2 miles away. We share the same home field. You know, and the coaches got mutual respect for each other. I know Coach Olsen, I know that, you know, they're up and coming and doing well with their program. And so are we, you know, so we like to think that we're, you know, we want to try and keep up with them and them keep up with us. And we're trying to push each other to get better. So we look forward to that game very much.
Coach, we gave the players the opportunity. I want to give you the same, give your quick hollers out to those who have supported not only Von Steuben, but this Panther football squad.
I know this is a long list, but I'll try and make it short for you. But I definitely want to support the families that are supporting us through this period. It's not easy. You know, the parents of the, you know, and players, you know, the parents, you know, and the families of the players, you know, with everything that they got to go through, all the protocols that they got to do, go through to stay healthy, all the sacrifices that they've made to be part of this season. You know, I thank my own family for supporting me. You know, I have the best coaching wife that there is. You know, I coach year round. So, you know, she's supporting me there. And then, you know, I also want to thank our school administration, you know, our athletic director, our principal, you know, Jennifer Sutton, Katie Hallberg, Patrick Rigge, you know, Mr. Urbina. Like these guys, our administration at Von Steuben really support Love Athletics and they support our football program. And so, you know, they give me everything that we need and they keep pushing us forward. And so that's, it's always great to have that type of support behind your football team. You know, not every school is that way. And so we're blessed to have an administration that really loves and supports our athletics and our team. So I'm very thankful for that. Real quick, man, I would be remiss if I didn't mention, you know, the seniors that are not present here, you know, Oscar Medina, Elijah Bancroft, Devont Pettis, Emiola Joasimi. You know, we got six seniors, man. And these guys I know have really stuck it out to really be part of this football season. And so, you know, I know I have two seniors that I love and excited about on this call, but we have four at home that are also just as special and really sticking it out for us. And so I'm very proud of them and thankful for them as well. You know,
we are staying up north on the north side as we venture into the Portage Park neighborhood. That's where our friends from the Foreman Hornets, who just got their first win of the season and joining us as a first-time guest of the show, is head football coach Carnell Hayes. Coach, we appreciate you joining us and talk about this team's first win this season coming off a tough loss last week.
Yeah, so last week was a tough loss, and we just vowed to never have another loss like that ever again this season. So we had to hit the practice again, get back into it, and get back into our groove. And I know a lot of players took film very serious this week to be able to come out and get this victory this week. So I appreciate guys for looking at film, taking over coaches' notes, and things of that nature. And I told them after last week's loss that I put that on me and my coaching staff for not getting them really prepared for the game speed. You know, we did a lot of X's and O's, and I don't feel we were ready for game speed. So I think we matched that energy, and we took that into the game against MLA, and we had a good bounce back. And I was very very proud on how they answered the call.
Coach, a 22-8 win over Marine Leadership Academy. You got to like that as well as the momentum it gives you going into the next game.
Oh yeah, definitely, y'all. And I just correct you a little bit. It was 22-6. We ain't give up that at the extra point.
I'm sorry, Coach. I admit, the defense. I apologize. The Hornets stink. I don't want y'all to put that. I gave them two extra points. That was on me, not Coach. Right. Hey, but Coach.
We definitely that. 22-6, and we held them a lot. Second half. We held them to no score, so that was a plus. That was
you
a victory.
Don't know me.
Coach, you got two of the shining stars of the game joining you. Tell us about these two young men and the game they played this week.
Yeah, so first we got Tamar Eastland. He's the anchor in the middle on offense and defense. He's the captain on the offensive line, captain on defensive line. He brings the intensity. I want to say I think he had five tackles, 3-4 loss, a forced fumble. And, yeah, like I say, man, he's the heart and soul of the defensive and offensive line. And secondly, we have Marion James. He's our wide receiver and DB. He's the one that's communicating. He's the one that's out there talking, chirping, getting everybody riled up for the game, getting everybody in tune on play calls and everything of that nature. And Marion was 5 carries, 35 yards. He was our tailback who got in the second half and just kind of held the pressure off our lead back. So he came in and did what he was supposed to do. Two-point conversions that was well needed to boost up our lead. But, those are the two players we have today.
Hey, well, let's meet our shining stars of the game. Tamon and Omarion, man, welcome to the H2S2 show. Tell the people what class you guys are representing and how it feels to get that first win. So let's start with you, Tamon.
I'm representing the class of 2022. And that win, it felt good because, you know, when your game's on Thursday, the next day Friday. So if you losing Friday, you're not going to enjoy it. So we enjoy our Friday today from that win.
Class 2022, we're joining, of course. And man, it just feel good. Like Tamon said, going home, completing your weekend, knowing your weekend, you got a W, it feels good. When we took that L, it feels good. We all just like, but this weekend, everybody can just go home, relax, and be looking for next weekend, be ready to watch film. Learn from our mistakes, what we did, but we really didn't make mistakes, but we still gonna learn and do better.
Now, speaking of what you learned to do better, what did you learn from the loss last week that motivated you guys to victory this week?
Like Coach said, our speed. So, we really went on the type, ready for the speed yet. So, we know we have to be at practice, be ready. So, we can, earlier we had practice, we get into it. So, instead of putting 100% at practice, going 200% every drill, we got to be ready for it. And, we just won and we executed, did good. We practice how we play, and we got the win.
Tamon, man, how does it feel moving forward? What are you guys going to continue to do, and what did you learn? You had a loss. Now you have a win. How do you put this together?
We learned a lot. We learned a lot about teamwork. Like Coach told us, teammate on ground, run to your teammate, help him up. From now on, our O-line, yesterday O-line was perfect. I don't think our quarterback got touched one time off a sack, anything. O-line was perfect yesterday. So from now on, O-line stay like that. It's no possible way we can lose.
I want to give both of you, let's start with you, Tamon. Who do you want to give big hollers out to?
I got to holler at my nephews because they the ones that push me to be great. Like every day they push me to be great. Just waking up to see them, it makes me happy. Kyson, Cashlin, both of them.
Big hollers out to everybody, especially my teammates because, it's one for them. No, everybody bringing that hard work at practice. Big hollers to my teammates. Big hollers to everybody that's been supporting me and my teammates. And I just want to say thank y'all and just keep it up. And this ain't it. This is not the only win we get. There's plenty more to come.
I like that. Coach Haynes, I'm interested in knowing after this shortened pandemic season, you have your first win. What's the goal for the Foreman Hornets during the pandemic season?
Okay, yeah, so with the shortened season, I don't really like to call it short. If we out there playing football, football is football. Like, you can't really think about it as being a short. Like, you just got to go in and get the work in that you want to get out of it, And this is just an opportunity to get better each week, week in, week out. You got to get better day by day. Don't no days off, no practices off, no games off. Just come in, work every day. It's been a long 13 months. A lot has happened to a lot of my players within that 13 months. And just to see them getting back to something that they love to do is exciting for me, because I get to see them every day, talk to them on the phone, get to see how their grades are going, how they get to practice, and just things of that nature. So it's just a lot to go in with that. So I'm just happy to be back with the team, and I know the team are happy. They're happy to be back with
Coach Haynes. Next week, the Hornets take on the Sin Bulldogs. What type of game do you expect?
All right, so I'll give props what props to do. I'm saying they got a few good athletes that we have seen on film so far. So we just gotta keep them on the wraps. Don't give up any big plays and just come in to play our game. Just lock in on film all this week and just come in and be ready to put in work just like we did this previous week. Learn from the first week, gain confidence from the second week, and then now we at the third week. So this is another another win that I feel like we should get. So I'm ready.
Coach, give out some hollers of your own to all the Foreman College and Career Academy supporters and Hornet football fans virtually cheering on your squad. Who are you giving hollers out to?
Yeah, so I want to all my staff, all my press crews, my ATs, just want to give shout-outs to all the teachers that that's emailing me, checking in on certain students that they feel aren't doing what they're supposed to do. They need a little bit of, a little bit of more motivation from me or my coaching staff. So, yeah, just I appreciate everyone that's involved and that's want to see these kids prosper and not just throw any kids under the bus, but they want to help them on the bus so we can all get to that goal of making a student athlete great.
As we head on over to Washington Park neighborhood, home to the Dyett Eagles, joining us as a friend of the show, the new head football coach, Marquise Reed. Coach, remember the last time we saw you? You were wearing a different jersey, man, but now you're here with the Eagles. Glad to have you back on, man.
Appreciate it. It's always fun.
Well, Coach, we got to talk about this move to Walter H. Dyett that has the Eagles flying high with a 66-0 win this week. Man, talk about it.
Well, Longwood, we just we're doing a pandemic. Just a lot of things got mixed up, so it wasn't no sports being had played at Longwood, and then just the future of it was in jeopardy. So I had Dyett, who worked with Coach Gill, the AD over there, and he brought me along. And when I got in there, it was just a whole different vibe, so a whole different environment. So I enjoyed it. Felt like home when I got in. So I made the move. I feel like I'm gonna be here for a while.
Well, Coach, you got these Eagles, as I said, flying high. Talk about these past 2 weeks for this football squad.
I think they had a good camp the last month. Our first game, our first week, was kind of back and forth. We had a couple of opponents drop and just getting a good form of an opponent in front of us. So I think we came out a little rusty, just getting our feet underneath us. We haven't had any live action in a while, which to be expected. They don't get much live action during the week. So just correcting a lot of errors. I think we did that this past week. And we was crisp yesterday, so we did a good job.
Well, Coach, you got two of the shining stars from the Dyett Eagles football squad. Tell us about these two young men we got today.
I got my quarterback, Cam Geis. I think he managed the game well for us yesterday. He's a senior, good to have him with us here today. Then I got my DN, tight play tight end, offensive line. He kind of played a little bit around Joshua. So he had a great game defensively. He had two touchdowns defensively, so he had a good game as well.
We got Cam. We got Joshua. Man, I want to hear from you guys. Tell the people what class you represent and how does it feel to be balling with the Dyett Eagles, man?
Class of 2022, and it feels good to play as an Eagle, represent the Eagle, and get that dub as an Eagle, man.
It feels good, to get a win with my guys. I feel like the first week was just a tune-up game. We worked the kinks out at practice, then just to get a 66-0 win, it just feels amazing,
Talk about the big shutout win this week, and how does that allow the team to come together, Joshua and Cam?
The difference between the first game was that was our first official game. Everybody was still kind of to get all these shakies and stuff. We only had a couple of days to practice. So from that time to this time, we were able to, shake out all the kinks, get out all the, butterflies in our stomach. Everybody went to this game with, our mindset and everything. We had our objectives and tags, and as the game showed, 66-0, we had everything under control.
Hey, Cam, you guys, 20 points in the first game, 66 points this week. What are the Dyett Eagles looking to improve upon and tell the rest of the Chicago Public League, man?
Basically that we here. We not here to play no games with no other schools. We basically to just get these wins. We want to continue how we are. We want to go undefeated. as long as we can. You know, we just want to keep winning, keep going together, keep striving, keep getting better, you know. Just like Josh said, the first week, we just this brand new team, getting all the shakes out. Then went to practice, corrected a few things, came back 66-0.
I want to give Josh and Cam an opportunity. Who do you want to give holler out to that's been supporting not only you, but big fans of Eagles?
Every parent that was there at the game supporting, because a lot of those parents have been there since day one, even when they thought we weren't going to have a season. They fought for us to have a season. They fought for Coach Reed to come there so we could have a season. I just want to give a shout out to them, because if it really wasn't for them, this wouldn't even be possible right now.
Shout out to Coach and everybody else, man, because I'm new to the program. So, you know, for me to come in as, you know, the new kid, it's kind of nervous, but they took me under their wing. They showed me the way, and they helped me on the path that I am now.
Coach Reed, your squad putting up big numbers. And I know as a coach, there's always something that you, particularly you, are looking to improve upon. What will you look for the Eagles to improve upon before the next game?
No, we just want to stay consistent. Like I tell the guys, we want to keep stacking the weeks, keep stacking the wins. So we go keep staying consistent. I want to see these guys keep working hard, you know, and take it as, you know, take it in stride, be humble about it. So just move on to the next week.
Coach, I believe next week, the Dyett Eagles against the Richards Warriors. What do you know about your next opponent, and what type of game do you expect to have?
I know they did a co-op with Harper, if I'm not mistaken. And I know my guys like Cam have lost to Harper, I would say maybe like sophomore year, Cam, freshman year. So I was just going to use this as a revenge week for him. So I expect it to be a good game. I expect it to be it would be a conference game. So I expect a lot of things being on the line. So it should be good.
Well, Coach, we gave the players an opportunity. You already know how this goes. Who do you want to give big hollers out to? That to all those Dyett supporters and Eagle fans cheering this team on virtually.
Man, just really, really to my AD, Coach Gill, and the principal and vice principal for, you know, we pushing for such a tight time to help make this happen. So, and then they, you know, show all the support they can to, you know, help me out for us to be successful. So
we head on over to the Pullman neighborhood on the city south side, and joining us is Corliss head football coach Keith Brookshire, whose Trojans have improved to 2-0 after a shutout win last week against the Dunbar Mighty Men, his alma mater, and another shutout win this week versus the Bowen Boilermakers, 52-0. Coach, thank you for joining us. Your squad is on the roll, man.
Appreciate you having me on the show, man.
Well, Coach, talk about these two victories that the Trojans have under your belt. Your team has been playing pretty well, 86 points in 2 weeks and two shutouts.
Yeah, that's big for the program. It's about a turnaround. So, you know, since I had the program, this is my second year. The pandemic kind of hurt everything because we were in a good offseason. So right now we're in a turnaround phase of Corliss football. And these victories just go a long way for boosting confidence, you know, in the kids to believe that, you know, they can win. Not only that, it does a lot for the building because it's hard to recruit the building. I come from a philosophy of take what you got in your building and build it. You know, I'm not going to be chasing kids, transfers, all of that. You know, I just like to take what I got in my building, mold it, coach it, and try to develop it into a program, you know, kids that understand football. And this is big for the building because the other kids in the building that sit back and, you know, talk smack all the time to the kids, man, y'all ain't that good, y'all, you know, they say stuff like that. So when you win, you know, they can't say that to you no more. And plus, it'll encourage some of them now to try and come out and join. And that's what I want because the numbers are down, you know what I mean?
Well, Coach, let's talk about two of the shining stars who performed very well for you. You got a young man by the name of Marquise Gales, who has 6 solo tackles, 3 pass defenses, and a 60-yard catch, along with a young man by the name of Ahmad Cooper. Tell us about these two shining stars of the game.
All right, so first I want to start with Gales, man, because he came so far. You know, he came a long way. Gales is not necessarily what you would look at as a football player. He was one of those kids out the building that just wanted something to do, came and played, and he played for me last year. And because of our numbers, he had to start, you know, at cornerback. And he got beat quite a bit last year, you know. So this year, I've noticed a different type of kid. You know, he's been at practice every day. He's perfected his back pedal. He's bettered his technique. And he's taking coaching better. He's understanding football now. So for him to come out yesterday, and I told him, man, and the team was so elated for him because it was his coming out party yesterday. I mean, he showed his butt. Yeah, he was coming up hidden. Man, he was coming up hidden, like tackling. So, you know, that was something that we didn't see out of Gales last year, but I've seen glimpses of it in practice. And then, you know, with his pass defenses, and he's, you know, he's not getting burnt. He's not getting beat. He did get beat once, but it was overthrow, you know, but he was recovering, you know, as the ball was thrown. And then on top of it, you know, I gave him a bone and threw him a touchdown. You know, I didn't throw him a touchdown, but I called his number, you know, I called his number on a play. And for him to run a 9 route, and he ran it perfectly, man, and the quarterback laid it in, and he got him 6 points. He got his first touchdown, man. He's so happy right now, man. I know he probably still at home doing flips. Amari Cooper, Amari Cooper, man, if you ever, and this for any program, if you ever had a kid that do everything right, it's Amari Cooper. He's my captain, or one of my captains. He's a senior. He's a 4.4 student in the classroom. He's a member of the ROTC. He's got a 4-year scholarship right now, man, on academics. He's a Posse scholarship winner. You know, he's in the Posse program. So his college is already paid for. He's just a wonderful kid that's going to be successful. He has great parents at home. And he's turned into a great football player. Before last year, he had never played football. But he's a pretty good athlete. So last year, he pretty much was in the gray area. He didn't know what he was doing much. He was on the field, and I would ask him, you know, he was a linebacker, and he'd stand still, you know, a lot. And, you know, linebackers, man, when the ball snapped, you got to come forward. You got to come on. So this year, he started to get it. And now he understands how to read. You know what I'm telling him to read, reading his keys better. He's coming off the ball, you know, when the ball snapped, he's hitting gaps. And yesterday he had an outstanding game. You know, he had about 6 or 7 tackles as well. He also plays, he's kind of light to be an offensive lineman, but he also does an excellent job on the offensive line too.
Well, we always give an opportunity to everybody that visits the H2S2 show to give out some hollers to those Corliss supporters and Trojan football fans. Who you want to give a big holler out to, Coach?
Man, my parents, I got a few parents, man, that supports us and that's at every game. We got a kid, Horace Hamilton, man, his mom, she's always behind us, always supporting us. Jeffrey Wardlow's mom, always behind us, always supporting us. And our quarterback, Torrance Branch, you know, this is his first year playing with us, but every game, you know, they haven't had fans in the game. Yesterday was supposed to be the first day they allow fans, but we were supposed to have a list. We didn't have the list. I didn't know that. I don't know how you can get a list of fans. Like, I'm supposed to make a list of fans. I don't know who's coming to the game. Anyway, his family is so supportive, man. He got a whole crew outside the gate. You know, he got 20 fans out there by himself. So our support has been good, although we haven't been able to have fans inside the stadium. We've had fans outside our stadiums, and they've been making a lot of noise, man. So the Corliss Village, you know, the Corliss Village is up and well. And we on our way up.
We got to make this quick. It's Sit the Kid coming at you right now. And I'm here to tell you to go check out my dad's podcast, The High School Holla Sports Show, on the Urban Fieldhouse Media website. That's urbanfieldhousemedia.com. And you can also check him out on all of his social medias at The H2S2 Show. That is YouTube, iTunes, Google Play, Facebook, Twitter. Just search up Urban Fieldhouse Media. And like my dad always says, God loves you and we do too. Until next week, come holler at my dad on the best show in Chicago for high school sports, the H2S2 Show!
Oh my God, I'm getting too loud. He's coming.
What are you doing?
High School Holla.